Welcome. This is new and old. Another car. This is a 97 Lincoln Town Car, believe it or not. And basically, this is, well, it was a project. Now it's a daily. Few things I still got to finish on it. When I got it, it was $800. That's what the guy asked for. After test driving it, it drove. Didn't drive very well, but it did drive. So I gave him $800 for it. What was wrong with this? Well, the biggest thing was the suspension was shot and the tires were completely gone. As you can see, the automatic door had to be fixed. It needs new window regulator. We'll do that. Again, this just had to be done. No big deal there. I imagine that broke. It did break. It was nothing with it. But today's task we're going to be tackling is this door hinge is basically broke. Previous owner drilled it too big, and then JB welded it to try to fix the issue. There's too much sag, and I went to the junkyard. Well, I had it delivered to me, and I got a hinge. This is the rear. This is the bottom. This is the bottom hinge. This is the top hinge. Now, I don't know. I am thinking, because this is obviously, I don't want to take this whole entire thing apart. This is obviously pretty much a permanent scenario hinge. Now, of course, when they did this, they cut the one right here, or the one that goes through the firewall. So I don't know why they did that, but I'm thinking if I cut this, I'll just cut it off, take it out. I have a kit that I should be able just to rehinge it. Plus, this is not the world's most best either. I mean, it's got some play in it too. It's not as bad, but it does have it. Because the scenario I'm running into is, yeah, I could just take this apart right here and, you know, take that. I think I can get in the back of this by just taking the bottom apart. But the problem is the bolt in the back there. I'm not sure if I can physically get that. And to be honest, this is broke anyways, so I think that's what we're gonna do. So let's get to it. First, we're going to go down to the garage. We're gonna cut this. Not bad Lincoln Town Car, really. I mean, it fires right up. I'm trying to get my... I'm gonna kick the AC off for a minute. Okay. I mean, let's see if I can get... I needed new brakes, needed new stuff like that. But, you know, all that stuff is normal. Biggest thing it was the suspension was shot. This does have a reclaimed title to it. And I think what happened was a ball joint came apart. Just old age just came apart. And they decided to total it, because it did have a reclaimed title. I don't know why it had reclaimed tie-dye. I asked about it. Of course, they lied to me about it, but whatever. So let's go over here. So let me put this right here. Well, I guess first thing is first, let's support this door. Let me go cut this and I'll be back. Okay, this is new and old. I'm back, a little out of breath, but as you can see, it's out. Now, if all goes according to plan, this should fit right there, and we should have a fixed door. We'll see. First, like all these door hinges, I gotta go get a cardboard here, 1 second. I believe this is hinged on a, well, it was, might not be. Okay, so in theory I should just be able to bring this out, which I can. Okay, that's right, because I didn't hit when I temporarily fixed this, I didn't hinge it, so I knew it would have to come undone again. Let's see here. It's gonna be a size, I think these are, yeah, 13 millimeter. Now make sure you have your door braced full, goes according to plan here. And that came undone. That comes undone. Hoping you guys can see this. And this, hopefully, sorry for the nasty hand my dermatologist was working on me. She burned off some skin problems. Anyways, this should come undone like so. Hoping you guys can see this because it's kind of at a weird angle, but I'm hoping. Okay, so that comes undone. Now when you're working on these Lincoln door hinges, they were kind of a funny bunch. This is a 97, I think 95 through 97 are the ones you have to look for if you're replacing these. And this is a common occurrence. My last link, my last Gen 2. Of course, this is a Gen 2. It's a very common occurrence on these Lincolns. That's why they sell the kit. And that should, in theory, come undone. Like that. And see what what I did is JB welded it. It worked. But now I've got a, if I can point you guys down, I've got a kit here. I bought this just off Amazon. It's for Lincolns. Gosh, Crown Vicks, Mercury's, had a list of them. I don't know. It did have a list though. So if I remember correctly, now these are actually easy. These actually have a bolt. And maybe we'll just, yeah, these actually have a bolt. So we'll put those right here. Now, when you put this when you put your, which I have all the way across, which I was not thinking. Okay. Well, this is it right here. And it's got to be, if I remember correctly, these have got to be in like that. They got to go in and in. Just like that. And then, in theory, if I can point you guys back over to the door, this should, you might have to maneuver your door, because remember, your door is now hanging. But if I remember correctly, it should. We have to be careful. Again, just use your noodle. That's your best bet here when doing this. Just like that. Then put your bolts back in, which miraculously I am right. The money. Of course, you may have to adjust things, so don't be surprised. Okay. Using, I could use an electric, but I'm choosing not to because I want the feel. I don't think this is going to be adjustable. Could be wrong. I don't think so. Okay, that's getting tight. We'll do the top one now. This one's going in pretty easily. Again, I got this from a junkyard. It was in Kirkland, Washington, I think. So I paid both $75 for these. So a little much on the totem pole, but that's okay. As long as it works, that's all we care. Okay, obviously it came from a white one, but that's okay. We can paint it. We can get some touch of paint. Just, you know, use your noodle when you're tightening these. Don't overdo it. You don't want it to come undone, but you also, I don't know what the torque spec is on this, but first, don't lose your wrench. Okay, that's good. Okay, now we should be able to lower this. Okay, then we have to put our nut on, but first, see what size nut this is. Gonna be a 13 too. Yeah, 13. Interesting. Okay. This may be easier with the electric. We will see. Okay. I'm back. Hopefully with the right tools this time. We'll see. Have you ever noticed with tools you never have enough? I don't know. I've noticed that. Of course, it's spinning. Interesting. Okay, I just have to hold it with the pick and that worked. Okay. That's the finished product. Okay, now I'll turn you guys around to our next little project. Okay. This doorstop has been very badly damaged, so we're going to replace it. Hoping with the right, that looks to be the right one. First guess. Okay. Now, should break off. Adjusted. Okay. I got these stops. I think it was from A1 Auto. I don't know. They just had them. And I think we're going to do, first we're going to screw her in. Maybe. It is obviously adjustable, so we're just gonna follow our witness marks right about there. A little bit tighter. Yeah, witness marks. I think we're gonna be. That's just my dad walking. Okay, I think we're going to do that. This was not actually very tight, I was surprised. Okay. Let me clip you guys off. Okay. Well, that's it. Let's see how she works. Ooh. We are way off on her. We are way off on her door. Oh, what do we do? Adjustable. So let's see how these adjust. I'm thinking, let's try this. See, there might be some adjustment. Supposedly this came off of a Lincoln. Okay, sorry about that, guys. My camera died. But this is it. This had to be adjusted. Again, I apologize for the yucky hand. Dermatologist. This had to be adjusted. This had to be adjusted, this had to be adjusted, and this had to be adjusted. And basically what I did is I just closed the door, lifted it up, and then it self-adjusted itself. I loosened up the bolts, but I didn't, and I just closed the door. Let me get up here. And I basically just closed the door and adjusted. And now it's pretty doggone close. I mean, you still gotta slam it. It's never gonna be perfect. But it's at least fixed. I mean, it's never gonna be perfect. Not by a long shot. Not in this car. But it's okay. I mean, again, this is pretty common for a Lincoln Town Car this era to do this. Also, the seatbelt breaks on them all the time. That seems to be a common occurrence on these Lincolns. Well, I don't know why it does it. What's the rhyme or reason why it does what they do, but seems to be every Lincoln that I've had has done this. Don't know why, but see, someone, they JB welded it is what they did, which worked. I mean, it held for a long time. Now the door stopped, that's garbage. This is garbage. Throw that in the, hold that in the metal pile. So, I mean, it's what it is. Next is gonna be that seatbelt. And I'm thinking we gotta take the seat out for that, as I don't think I can get to the bolt. So, anyways, this is a 97 Lincoln Town Car door hinge replacement. Have a good one.